I rise in support of H. Res. 608, introduced by Congresswoman Lois Capps, which is a bipartisan resolution to offer condolences to the Isla Vista and University of California Santa Barbara communities, to mourn the victims and offer support to their families. It condemns the senseless rampage and urges a dialogue on, quote, the nation's mental health care system, anger, firearms laws, harmful attitudes towards women, unquote. The resolution honors law enforcement and emergency personnel for their response to the attack and continues the commitment of, quote, working to help prevent tragedies like this from happening again, unquote. The rampage and mass shooting that left six UC Santa Barbara students dead and 13 others injured in Isla Vista May 23rd was perpetuated by a deeply troubled man with violent tendencies who planned for months to kill as many as he could before the tragic day unfolded. Despite warnings from his parents to police and a subsequent law enforcement check a few weeks before the murders, Elliot Rogers was able to cleverly ward off police by passing off the warnings as a, quote, misunderstanding. Police said later that Roger did not meet the criteria for an involuntary hold. He legally purchased more than 400 rounds of ammunition and three semi-automatic pistols over the course of months before his rampage. In the months up to the shooting, Elliot Rogers posted numerous videos and comments on social media sites detailing his frustrations with women and his hatred of them. He made such comments as, quote, my orchestration of the day of retribution is my attempt to do everything in my power to destroy everything I cannot have. All of those beautiful girls I've desired so much in my life, but can never have because they despise and loathe me, I will destroy, unquote. He said he would also eliminate the men who had better luck with women than he did. Roger distressingly joins a long list of mass killers that have haunted this country in recent years at grim scenes including Sandy Hook, Virginia Tech, Aurora, Tucson, Walmart in Las Vegas, and now in Oregon just minutes ago. Roger shares three common denominators with these other mass murderers: easy access to guns, a history of mental illness, and clear warning signs that he wanted to carry out violent acts. Together, the five lone killers left a staggering 82 people dead and 114 others injured and scarred. The Sandy Hook killer had serious mental health issues. The man who shot Representative Gabby Giffords had dropped out of school after his college required a mental health evaluation. The Virginia Tech killer had been investigated by the university for stalking and had been declared mentally ill by a Virginia special justice. The Isla Vista shooter also had a long history of mental illness. What's it going to take, colleagues? What's it going to take? Like many other mass shooters, he showed clear signs that he was extremely dangerous and planned to kill. But massacres are only a fraction of the mass shootings Americans have endured in a short span. Between January 2009 and September 2013, there were 93 mass shootings, almost two per month, that occurred in 35 states in nearly a five-year period. Is the problem too many guns? Is it mental health? Is it guns in the wrong hands? The answer to all these questions is yes. We know what needs to be done. We may not agree on every solution to reduce gun violence, but Americans, outraged by our inability to get anything done on this issue, are waiting for us to come to our senses and to act. The threshold for taking someone against their will for psychiatric evaluation needs to be reviewed. Police need better mental health training. It must become easier to intervene when there are risks. The prevailing majority of individuals with a mental health problem aren't violent, but we should have the tools to respond to the smaller number who show clear violent tendencies and evidence that they are preparing to act on it. Richard Martinez, the father of slain 20-year-old Christopher Michaels Martinez, tearfully pleaded for people to stop feeling sorry for him after the massacre. His words ring in my ear all the time. Quote, I don't care about your sympathy. I'm going to ask every person I can find to send a postcard to every politician they think of with three words on it. Not one more. People are looking for something to do. I'm asking people to stand up for something. Enough is enough. One more mass killing is too many, and Congress is culpable for not taking action. We say never again, but it sounds like an empty promise because we do nothing. I thank Congresswoman Capps for offering this thoughtful and important resolution. We need to do so much more, and her bringing this resolution to our attention gives us the opportunity to draw together and hopefully to come up with something to do. With that, I reserve the balance of my time.